Hey everyone, it's me.
Let's do that again!
Hey everyone, it's me, Dan the Film Jet, and welcome back to another video. And I know I'm a little bit late, sorry, you know, things I'm not on YouTube 24/7, so I kind of am. I can't post everything here and there, so I figured collect the thoughts, you know, take some time to like go over what you discovered, you know, before shooting the breeze, you know what I'm saying? So first preseason just came, and originally we were supposed to have one I think today or yesterday, but because of Milton, which by the way, again, you know, I've said this before, but I hope everyone's doing okay. I know we just got through one of the worst storms in Florida history. I heard a Rays baseball stadium just got, you know, demolished, or the roof got torn to shreds. And I hope everyone's okay over there. Just to see everything like that just happen. Like, my condolences go out to you, and I sympathize with you. It's going to get better from here on then. I hope you get the best insurance, even though that can be like a pain just to get the right insurance to help your welfare and everything. I really hope everything goes good for you, you know, and just be okay, you know. We'll get through this. I hope so. And my condolences go out to you. Go to anywhere that you can to, like, you know, make the full recovery. And I hope every part of your life gets well or better. Anyways, but that being said, so yeah. As I said before, the first preseason against the Hornets was, even though we lost, I don't care about the loss, and I don't care. I just care about, you know, witnessing and, you know, critiquing certain players. When the main starters came in, I was like, okay, I was a little bit bored, and like going into the game, I'm like, okay, we know what they can do. I'm not interested in them. But then once the third quarter comes and you enter like Kel'el Ware, Keshad Johnson, Isaiah Stevens, Pelle Larson, And Caleb Daniels, which by the way, I heard he just got waived to go to the Sioux Fox Falls. So good luck to him. You know, I knew he wasn't going to make the roster, but he's quite the hell of a playmaker. Pelle Larson looked astounding. All right, originally I wasn't really intrigued with Pelle Larson. I wasn't too hyped about him when we traded for him in the draft. I'm thinking, okay, maybe he's like Duncan in a way that he's just a catch and shoot 3-point specialist. Like, he moves around the arc. He doesn't really, like, have, like, any, like, I don't know how to say it. Like, mostly to operate down the field, to operate on the fast break or anything like that. I was thinking, okay, maybe he's just, some people said he was, like, Max Strus, but I didn't really see that from the highlights. And going into the summer league, I was just kind of like, okay, you know, he did some things here and there, but it wasn't until the final two summer leagues when we won the summer league, that's when my mind changed. And I'm like, okay, wow, all right, never mind. I should keep my mouth shut. And yeah, I've heard he's been, you know, doing extremely, extremely well in the preseason, or even in the training camp as well, or even the scrimmage that happened. I think, what was it, like 21 points? I mean, not to say he's NBA ready yet, but I like what I'm seeing so far. Now, could it be like the same situation as Jaime, where Spo inserts him into a rotational piece? Or into a rotational player, that remains to be determined. And the biggest news by far, Superman Ware, Kel'el Ware. Wow. I mean, not too flashy, but he showed something. He showed a lot in his debut. From the defensive end, from the offense. I mean, granted, his offense game needs to a little bit work. And condition-wise, you know, it still needs to be a little bit steady as well. But, you know, I wouldn't say he's a dangerous in the post, but he's very crafty in the post, and he's very, like, crafty shooting beyond the arc with, like, that 1 3-pointer. Granted, yes, he missed the game-tying shot to tie the game, but I don't care about that. I mean, I'm fine with that because, one, it's preseason, and two, it shows that there's some type of accountability and there's some type of adversity in these young guys, especially Keshad. You know, taking the chance, not being afraid of the moment, and just taking, you know, that last shot, you know, just to take a chance to do something like that. Try to, I won't say be a leader, but be somewhat of a commanding officer on the court. But either way, you know, Keshad, Kel'el is another one that, you know, I'm highly praised. I'm very high on Keshad Johnson. Ooh. He's so, I mean, it's not too much big showing, but just the athleticism and the jumps and the hype and just like his mobility on the court. Oh my gosh. It is so wonderful to see. People keep saying like he's PJ Tucker. I don't know. Like I would say he's more what's that guy's name? LaMarcus Aldridge. I forgot his name. Paul Millsap. He's more like athletic Paul Millsap, at least for me. Well, I mean, maybe without the jump shot, but who knows? But Keshad Johnson is another one that I'm going to keep my eye on. But back to Kel'El, man. Kel'El Ware was astounding. More very astounding. I know people say, oh, he probably might not get many minutes from Spo. He might go to the G League. I don't think that's going to happen. Guys, I don't think we're going to draft a first rounder just to send him to the G League like we did with Jovic. Now, we have to understand that, yes, Kel'el is still pretty young. He's about 19 or 20. Whereas, like, Jovic was, like, still a high school kid playing in, like, a different league of basketball. So, it was understandable for Jovic because for him to transition into from European basketball to this American to the American style can be a little bit hard and a little bit tricky. So it was understandable to, like, you know, condition Jovic to, you know, give him some time and, like, let him develop his game in a sense into the G League and show what his offensive will can, you know, be of use. Now, I agree that he might not get a lot of minutes. I don't think, yeah, because people keep saying, oh, he's going to start against Bam. I mean, I wish, but knowing Spo, I don't think that's going to be the case. I think we're going to see the same lineup with Jovic and Bam. I think we're just going to see, like, a little bit of Bam's, like, starting at the five again. And I think Jovic has, like, kind of cemented himself as, like, the power forward rotational piece that can space the floor and also can be add some dynamics in the offensive game. Not really, like, the main, the missing piece, but he's an optional. He's just a great, you know, stand around, like, good spacer. But defensive game, that remains to be seen because we've seen flashes of it, yes, last year. But at the same time, you know, he does get in a little bit of a trouble when it comes to defending his opponents. A lot of times he takes the bait, gets fouled, and it will cost the team a lot. So who knows? But Kel'el Ware, I think there's going to be a chance to see him maybe in, like, in the middle of the season, like in January or December. That's when I can see Kel'el, like, get a chance to shine. But he's got to work on a lot of things, you know. I'm not going to say he doesn't look ready, but there's some things he does, still needs time to develop. There's there's some skills of him that shows me that, okay, he needs a little bit more time. Like, he doesn't look fully ready, but he looks flashy enough. He looks very, like, tough, gritty. I mean, not really tough, but you know what I mean. Like, very talented on both ends of the side, on both ends of the court as well. Yeah, and Isaiah Stevens should get the two-way because I don't know why Drew Smith. I don't know. Even when we first, like, signed Drew Smith and we played him, like, I think a couple years ago when we were the eighth seed going into the finals, I still was not intrigued by Drew Smith. Something about his game just doesn't, like, you know, move me. Like, people keep saying, like, oh, he's the same as Gabe Vincent. I'm like, I don't think so. Gabe Vincent was just more of, like, a grin and grind type of guy that can, like, just irritate his opponents, whether on the defensive end or the offensive end. Whereas Drew Smith doesn't really have those same qualities. I don't know. That may just be me. Now, I understand that if they want to keep Drew Smith because he has experience under Spo, and they've used him as a backup court point guard because we haven't addressed that yet, which I would love to do that, but I don't think we're going to do that until probably, like, later in the season when we have to make a trade. I mean, who knows? Now, people are, like, a little bit down on Terry because he had a pretty bad game, which I'm not going to focus too much into that because, you know, I did expect some rust into him, especially when he had that neck injury from last season that he couldn't play in the Boston series. So I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt. I'm going to go easy on him because we know what Terry can do. We know what he's capable of. We know the perks and the abilities that he can bring on this team. But either way, man, I'm pretty excited about the young guys, you know? I can't wait to see what happens for the rest of the preseason, because it looks like a fun group of guys, and I do hope Jaime gets better. You know, for him to get a groin injury like this early already, it's not looking good. Not looking good, but I think Jaime's still going to get a chance. I do expect Jaime to, like, you know, make a much better improvement this year. If his groin injury isn't that too much, if it isn't too much. Like it was, like, in the later second half of the season. But we will see. And I'm not going to talk about Tyler Herro because we've already said enough about Tyler Herro. But either way, man, I'm excited. I don't know what to expect. I can't wait for tomorrow. We play tomorrow? Yeah, tomorrow against the Pelicans. I'll probably get the highlights of it. I probably won't watch the game because I'm probably going to be a little bit busy. But either way, we will see what happens for the rest of the preseason. All right. If you like this video, hit the like button, comment down below, and subscribe if you want to. You know, it's your own free will, your just choice. All right, guys. Have a good day, and let's go Heat. Let's go Heat.